everyone, this is Little Miss Writer 09 back again with another video, and today I'm going to do my book review on The Cat That Ate My Gym Suit by Paula Denziger. I don't know if I'm saying her last name right. Please, and you know, comment to see if I'm mispronouncing it. That's how her name is spelled. Okay. And this story is, well, it's been a while since I actually read this book. Holy moly. Let me read you the synopsis of what this is all about. Marcy Lewis hates school, her father is a tyrant, and she despairs of ever being thin. Then along comes Miss Feeney, an English teacher who's willing to try anything in a classroom and who treats the kids like human beings. Marcy had never met anyone like her. Suddenly, life has a new meaning. And this book is still, even today, you know, as I am getting older, it's still a really good book. It's mostly a coming of age story. Marcy Lewis is, you know, I mean, this is she tells the story in her point of view. Marcy Lewis, she's 13. She's basically overweight. She has poor self-image. She lives at home with her mom, who's kind of very, you know, this nice woman, very submissive, as you would say, with her little brother who is, you know, he's kind of a baby, and so I think he's like in like 5 or 6 years old and sucking his thumb, and he holds his teddy bear. And her father is he's such an asshole. He treats his family like crap. He kind of wants his daughter to, her, you know, he's always trying to discourage Marcy. He's always discouraging his son for being such a baby. He's pretty much a jerk off in this story. And I really feel bad for Marcy, because you could tell, like, why she feels so insecure with herself. And it's funny, even in school, she fails gym, or failing gym, is because she doesn't like to wear her gym suit. She always has an excuse to her gym teacher, saying that the cat ate it, or she left it at home, or, you know, she says something funny, you know, in a way. I kind of feel bad for her. Even in English class, things started to change when Miss Finney, she's like, I think, in her 20s, and she comes to be their new English teacher. And things start to change because not only she makes learning fun, she also treats the students like people, like human beings. You know, I'm not going to diss anyone who's a teacher, but, you know, like, I'm not going to say anything bad about teachers or anything, but there are some teachers who are very demanding, whereas a teacher not only makes learning fun, but, you know, for them wanting to learn, and also, you know, learn about themselves in a way, and be very, you know, you could be, you know, open yourself up and stuff like that. And I really like Miss Finney, because she's just an interesting character. She's nice, and I like how she and Marcy, like, she kind of knows Marcy has issues, and she tries to help with that self-esteem and all that stuff. And things start to get worse when Miss Finney goes to court, because apparently she does something that is quote-unquote taboo, but illegal, or, you know, it's a constitution, she's not an American, all this other bullcrap. And I'm not gonna say what it was, because that's kind of like spoiling, but yeah. And the kids actually fight back to get Miss Feeney, get her job back, and just stand up for what's right. And she motivates these children to stand up for what they believe in and stuff like that. So I really like this story. This story is still relevant to this day, to believe it or not. This was written, like, I think in the 1970s. And it's still a relevant story. Yeah, you know, years and, you know, all the crap we're going through right now in America. I don't even want to say it, but this is a still relevant book. Even if it's like a middle school book, I think you should really check this out. It's a very coming-of-age story, and even as an adult, you still learn from, you know, things, especially especially coming from a young teenage girl in this story. Not young, but she's 13, but you could still relate to this story and what's going on today, especially in the school system and stuff like that. So I get this book, just, you know, just because I really like this, I get this 5 out of 5. Very easy to read, very well written, relevant to this day, and, you know, it doesn't matter how old you are, you still, please check this book out, especially if you're of that age. So, yeah, that's it, guys. I hope you liked this video. I'm sorry I have not done a book review in a while. Sorry if I'm a little forgettable because I only read this about 4 weeks ago, so. So, but hope you guys have a good Sunday or wherever you are. I hope you guys have it's Sunday here, depending on when or what time you're watching this. Hope you guys have a good day, night, wherever you are. Until then, this is Little Miss Writer 09, and I will do more book reviews coming soon. Yeah. Peace out. I'm out. Bye.